ever since the birth of smartphones, there has been one discussion that rages in fan forums, either iOS or Android. But now, with the release of the Mate 70 lineup from Huawei, there's a new entrance, Harmony OS Next. So, what does this new smartphone operating system mean for this blood feud between iOS and Android? And why did Huawei decide to create it in the first place? All of that coming up next on TechAsia. But to understand why Huawei is creating its own operating system, you have to understand a little bit more about Huawei. Huawei has been talking for a very long time about creating its own app ecosystem, follow me, its own app ecosystem to be able to link up its smartphones and its computers and its tablets. Huawei has actually a lot of products, from smartphones, laptops, smart home devices and tablets, partnerships with car makers, to glasses that have speakers embedded in them. I don't know how well you can actually hear them from this microphone, but quite similar to actually the functionality that you would get from the Meta smart glasses, to regular earbuds, smart watches that they also develop the OS for. Seeing all of this helps us understand a little bit better of why Huawei wants to create its own ecosystem. It has a lot of devices that it can plug in, very similar to Samsung or a Google or an Apple want to have control of their own ecosystem. Huawei is doing just that, but with its home market in China. Just because they wanted to build it, though, doesn't mean that they wanted to have to develop it all at once. They weren't exactly given the choice, though. In 2019, Huawei was subject to quite harsh sanctions from the US that meant they were no longer able to access any services from US companies. So that means chips, and that means also software. That was, well, what many thought to be a killing blow for the brand, but it's returned with a vengeance in the last couple of years with its own homegrown chips, with its own homegrown camera sensors, cars. So when Huawei was banned from Google services being used back in 2019, they had to find their own way to create their own operating system and find more resilience. This is the Mate 70 Pro. It's running Harmony OS Next, Huawei's completely in-house developed version of a smartphone operating system. Just because Huawei developed it doesn't mean that people who use smartphones will be completely out of their depth. It's a very similar operating system compared to Android or iOS. On the laptop side, Huawei will be releasing its first laptop running Harmony OS Next on the 19th of May. This is Huawei's replacement for Microsoft Windows, which it no longer has a license to. So it boasts an AI-powered assistant, as well as deep integrations with Huawei devices and laptops, as well as an interface that looks quite similar to the smartphone, so large buttons that can be pressed with a touchscreen. This is the result of more than 5 years of work, according to Huawei. And though they've not talked much about it, it will be running a custom Huawei-made chip, which makes it very similar to the Apple Silicon Macs that were released back in 2021. Pop quiz. These two phones run Harmony OS and Harmony OS Next. I don't think I could actually tell the difference between what phone is running which operating system. Like, if I go into the notifications, this looks exactly the same. While it looks the same on the outside, it is actually a lot of work to create an application for two different operating systems. So already balancing Android and iOS, a lot of developers are giving a lot more priority to their iOS apps. And it's the same thing if you add a third player like Huawei's Harmony OS into the mix. It's going to take a lot of effort for developers to create three different versions of their apps. Thankfully for Huawei, it's positioned in a way very similar to how Apple is positioned in the rest of the world. For context, Huawei has a similar market share in China than Apple does in the rest of the world, so around 14%. And on top of being the third largest smartphone maker in China, Huawei is also the third largest laptop maker in China. That means that Huawei has pretty good incentives to give to developers to come and create their own custom app for Harmony OS Next. So that's not to say that the Harmony OS Next doesn't have any compromises. For example, well, I was looking for Genshin Impact on the app gallery and didn't find anything, which means that not all popular games are actually already ported to Harmony OS Next. I haven't been able to confirm that Genshin Impact is still unavailable since I recorded, but my point still stands that certain applications will not be available on these platforms. This is going to be the biggest challenge in Huawei's development and deployment of its desktop operating system. They are targeting this launch at office workers for the time being. So that means productivity suites like WPS Office, which they made a big deal about in marketing, But that also means that creative suites like Adobe are not going to work, as well as games, which is a very big factor. As of the 9th of May, there were only 300 apps available natively for Harmony OS Next, which is tiny compared to what you would have on Windows, Linux, or macOS. It is important to have realistic expectations of what launching a new OS really looks like. So for example, Windows on ARM took more than 10 years to develop. It does take a long time to get developers on board, but Huawei has maybe an ace up its sleeve. It's talking about having developers develop apps for the smartphone and at the same time deploying them to the desktop. So having government agencies like, I believe, in Shanghai saying we will develop apps and platforms for this operating system gives a lot of legitimacy to Harmony OS Next. This is where Huawei positioning itself as a patriotic hero plays in their favor. Users on Weibo are very enthusiastic about this as a win for China's domestic tech industry. And so this vertical integration actually allows them to create something pretty cool. You select it, and you go up onto the next device, you slowly release, and then it ends up on the phone, which is wicked cool. It's a bit gimmicky because it doesn't work every time, and transfer it. This is pretty cool, if it had worked. Yeah. No, this takes a screenshot. I mean, this is the kind of fun thing that you don't really see with a lot of devices these days, and that's why I'm really a fan of this operating system. So Huawei's not given us too many details about Harmony OS Next, so I'm quite curious if they will adopt the Chrome OS model, where Google basically just gave away I don't know how many millions of laptops to schools. That is what gave Google this huge advantage in getting market share in education and enterprise. And that doesn't seem to be what Huawei is doing. So they're positioning themselves as a much more premium brand. If Huawei wants to keep Harmony OS Next for themselves, will they create a very cheap laptop that they can then give to schools and create a similar system that Chrome did with Chrome OS? Also, will Harmony OS Next be very locked down in the way that like smartphone operating systems are locked down? Or will it be something that developers can use, install their own applications and everything? So I haven't had too many details about this, and I'm looking forward to learning a lot more about Harmony OS Next when it launches for the desktop on the 19th. In the meantime, I think it's a really interesting concept that Huawei has announced with Harmony OS Next. The limitations on the applications and the hardware that it's going to be able to run on, I think are going to be challenges that we'll have to stay tuned to figure out if it actually matters in the future. But until next time, from the Huawei flagship store, I guess you'll just have to take care.